I did something. I finally built my home studio. So about a year ago, ever since the second bedroom in my apartment got vacant, I had the idea of turning this into like a studio or like a creative space or something like that. Whether it was for my podcast with my friends or like a man cave or something like that. But then it dawned on me that my studio setup that was stuck in my bedroom really needed an upgrade, especially for how serious things are getting now. I've been so fortunate to link up with so many dope artists, talented rappers, singers, and other producers and mixing engineers that I needed a place that was more professional than what it used to be. The bedroom setup was great, but I was feeling so tired and lazy, and like I didn't want it to be in the same space that I would sleep at every night. I wasn't feeling that motivation and that extra energetic drive that I needed to sit down and produce music and film myself. Also, from a content perspective, it's not as appealing to look at a bedroom than it is to look at a studio. Although this does look like a casting couch type of setup, this is the back end of the studio. My main goal for this studio space was to have it more open and more laid back and have space for people to kind of walk around and kind of come up with ideas in their head rather than being restricted in a small space where there's a bed occupying a whole bunch of space and a bunch of other things. And because I was meeting with so many people, I wanted to keep my personal stuff away from my professional stuff. This studio has been a dream of mine, but I did the best that I could with whatever I had. Obviously, I'm a college student, I'm on a budget, so I DIY'd a bunch of stuff and just moved around whatever I already had in my apartment. The space has been done for a couple weeks now, but I'm just finally excited to share with everyone how it turned out. And more than ever before, I'm feeling that drive to push out some new music, some great content, and finally give the people what they want. That being said, there'll be an official announcement later, but for now, I have a song releasing on January 2nd, and January 7th. On January 2nd, my boy Mannequin is releasing a song called Good Times that I myself produced, mixed, and mastered. And he gave me a verse to feature on, so that's a first. On January 7th, I'm releasing a song called Waste My Time featuring Mannequin. I'm really excited for this new wave of content I'm putting out and the slight rebrand that I have going on. With that being said, I think it's time to show everyone the studio. Studio space that I have is accessibility. I wanted the workflow to be faster. I wanted me to be able to work with other people better and not have to move things around or move my interface around or cables around every single time I wanted to work on something. So to get started, we'll talk about my desk setup. The thing that is different are my speakers from last time. So these reference monitors are the new JBL 104 series. The old speakers that I had were the Edifier 980Ts, and yes, they're speakers, not really reference monitors. I needed reference monitors to, you know, perfectly fine-tune the music that I was making, to hear the perfect high-ends, the low-ends, the mid-range. I needed reference monitors and not speakers that would make my music sound better than it actually was. And the whole concept behind the 104 series from JBL is to make pro-level sounding reference monitors in a compact size and affordable price range. As for my interface in my desk, it's the same M-Audio Fast Track. We just have the cables routing in and out of it to go to the places that I wanted it to go. So the headphone out is in a regular headphone splitter with one going to the recording booth, which I'll show you later, and the XLR heading to the recording booth, and one right here for artists who want to track, mix, or listen. Below that is just a storage space for my mic equipment and my camera equipment. So furniture and room layout wise, I wanted a more open space, a place where people could move around, you know, have their guitars around without the fear of bumping into things or bumping into people. This is more like a chill hangout spot where artists would feel more comfortable to, you know, write music, talk about things, kind of give their feedback, kind of sit back and relax, and also hear the music from further away and kind of give in their input while I or another mix engineer are like producing or mixing the music. And as you may have noticed, yes, I do have foam panels all around the room. I wanted to sound treat this room as best as I can with whatever I have. Obviously, acoustic foam panels are very expensive and I'm on a tight budget and I didn't want to pour in too much money. You know, professionals might cringe at this, but these foam pads are actually my old mattress toppers from freshman year wrapped in bed sheets. I wanted to cover this room as best as I can with the foam panels and, you know, with whatever I got. So I have two foam panels there around the corner, so if there are reflections, they can bounce off. Same with here by the door, another one by the wall, another corner there with three on the back wall, with the biggest one being in the center. Later on, the center panel is going to be painted or made into a sign to have, you know, a decorative purpose as well. That's why it's a different color and it's going to be covered in something different. I also have my Jordan 1 neon light here for decorative purposes because it's the greatest shoe of all time. For lighting, I have an LED strip going all across, all around the ceiling. It's RGB color changeable, so we can change it to whatever vibe we're feeling. Right now it's like a bluish white, which goes perfectly well with the neon sign. As for the recording booth, I really, really wanted to get this right. So down here we just have two blankets to avoid any extra reverb coming from underneath the mic. Here we have two comforters hanging about a foot away from the wall to have that air pocket where sound can, you know, pass through and come back and still get absorbed twice by the comforters. In addition to that, behind the comforter, there's another larger foam panel than this one, occupying the area of that space behind the mic to further absorb any more sound. And if that wasn't enough, I have another foam panel up here that I made from actual sound deadening home insulation that I got from Home Depot, and that absorbs any sound that goes over that shelf and hits that corner up there and comes back down. I made this recording booth as isolated as I could while still keeping it accessible to everyone that wanted to record. It's still sitting on the same mic stand, except the mic stand is inverted this time and it's hanging from that shelf up there, and it's height adjustable, so it can range from, you know, shorter artists to taller artists. Right now it's set to my preferred height, so yeah, that's a recording booth. So as I mentioned before, I wanted this studio to be accessible to everyone. I wanted the workflow to be faster. So what I did was I invested in some longer cables. I got a 30-foot XLR cable going from the interface, routing all the way around into the mic. This is hidden up there and just comes down here. So from far away, or even up close, it looks so neat. Secondly, I got an aux extension for the headphones that artists wear while they're recording. So obviously while artists are being tracked, we need one for the producer or mix engineer, and we need one for the artist recording. The aux extension goes all the way into the booth right here, where headphones can be connected, and the headphones just sit up there. So yeah, that's basically it for the studio tour. I'd love to hear feedback if some of you guys are more experienced in building something like this. You know, it's the best that I could make it with whatever I have, and it's only gonna get better from here. The future plans for the studio, again, like I said, are a sign over there to make it more personal, a couple bass trap foam insulations up in the corners, and probably more foam insulation for the recording booth, because you can never have too much insulation there.
So, I hope you enjoy the new content, I hope you like the new studio setup, and if you do have any suggestions, please send it my way through the comments. Anyway, time to get to work. Peace.